Hear another tale of Tempest Fugonaut and see another future of the DC Universe that could have been. All this and more in the pages of Tales from the Dark Multiverse Infinite Crisis issue number 1. Now we all remember Infinite Crisis, right? It was a 2005 to 2006 event that saw the survivors of the original Crisis on Infinite Earths, Alexander Luthor, Superboy-Prime, Old Superman, and Old Lois plot to try and fix what they thought to be the moral failings of the superheroes of the main Earth. It was a massive sprawling storyline, but before the ball even got rolling on all of that, one man actually figured it out. One man actually knew a crisis was coming and tried to stop it. That man was Ted Kord, the second Blue Beetle. Blue Beetle had tried to voice his concerns to Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman, but they blew him off because, after all, he's just a bug, right? Just a second stringer, a guy who hangs out with Booster Gold too much. Knowing too much also ended up bringing him into conflict with Maxwell Lord, the leader of Checkmate, who currently was working on a plan to get the Brother Eye satellite online. Lord hated all metahumans and had hoped to try and recruit Ted to his cause. After all, he was just a normal human too, gifted with an amazing mind. In the original story, Kord refused to join Lord, and it makes me laugh that that actually rhymes, and because of it, Kord ended up executing Blue Beetle. Here in the Dark Multiverse, though, things end up going differently, and Blue Beetle gets out of the situation by doing what he probably should have done to begin with, and that is pretend to work with Maxwell Lord only so he can turn the tables on him later. Which, in this case, actually involves taking his gun and shooting him in the head. Ooh, boy, that's a little bit extreme. I guess they don't call it the Dark Multiverse for nothing, eh? It's after that things start moving very quickly. Kord gets cornered by Sasha Bordeaux, another member of Checkmate, and also spy for Batman. Kord ends up surprising her, though, when he actually manages to get the Brother One satellite back under control. It, by all rights, shouldn't work without Maxwell holding its leash, but Kord realizes that Brother Eye has evolved beyond its normal parameters. It's a living, thinking AI now, and instead of treating it like a tool or a weapon like Lord was doing, he's going to treat it like a person. And they vow to work together using Checkmate's vast resource pool to stop this infinite crisis before it even has a chance to get started. The truly hilarious and admittedly pretty tragic part about all of this is that Kord's actions go pretty much undiscovered by everyone in the superhero community because, again, he's a bug, he's insignificant. In fact, the only person who seems to care at all is Ted's best friend, Booster Gold. He tries to get the Justice League involved, but once again, the Trinity blows him off. As far as they're concerned, they got their own fish to fry right now, and they really can't be bothered by this hilarious time traveler and his issues, something that they will live to regret. You see, Ted Kord is already starting to make some major moves. Remember how Infinite Crisis had like a billion tie-ins and a ton of sub-events? Well, Blue Beetle starts working his way through all of them. First off, he uncovers Lex Luthor's plan to build a brand new clandestine version of the Secret Society of Supervillains, why he even manages to recruit the Secret Six, and stop a full-scale villain civil war before it even starts. He also stops the Eclipso gem from falling into the hands of Sue Dibney's killer. He warns Wizard Shazam and the rest of the magical community in the DC universe that the Spectre might go insane and start a lot of trouble for them, why he even uses OMAC robots to stop the Ran-Thanagar War. Blue Beetle even has some harsh words to Batman, saying that the only reason the Brother Eye satellite would have gone crazy is because, well, Batman put a lot of himself into the project and Batman is himself a little bit crazy. Batman wants to bring Ted Kord in because, after all, he murdered Maxwell Lord, but Blue Beetle says, "Why would you want to stop me now? I'm literally on a roll. I'm doing all your jobs for you now." With a more direct approach failing, it's Booster Gold who hopes that he can appeal to what little is actually left of his friend, saying that what he's doing right now is crazy. This is too much power for one person to hold. Ted respectfully disagrees, though, saying he's still the same person he always was. It's just now he has vision and a goal. Maybe he didn't want to spend the rest of his life as a D-lister. Maybe he actually wanted to do what all superheroes do, and that is save the world. Even if that means getting his hands a little bit dirty. Now, Checkmate's next mission is actually tracking down the mysterious Mockingbird, the leader of the Secret Six, and yet another person pulling the strings behind all the supervillains. Of course, if you were reading comics at that time, you'll know the original Mockingbird was ultimately revealed to be Lex Luthor, but not the main Earth Lex Luthor, Alexander Luthor of Earth 3. Oh, sure, Blue Beetle may have put out a bunch of different fires, but he still can't quite stop the infinite crisis from happening. It's almost damn near inevitable. Alexander Luthor pleads his case to Ted, talking about how dark, grim, and unforgiving the DC universe has become, and that through him, they're going to put everything back in its proper place and restore peace. Once again, Blue Beetle actually uses his weaponized logic in this situation, saying, oh, so you wanted to bring peace by tearing the universe apart. In case you haven't noticed, me and Checkmate have actually managed to fix a lot in a short amount of time. This argument proves to be more than enough to convince Superboy Prime, Alexander Luthor's ace in the hole, to turn tail and defect to Cord's team. Why was that so easy? Well, because he's crazy and ultimately has the morality and idealism of a child, so yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Thankfully, though, Superboy Prime is less whiny and takes up less page real estate here than he did in the actual Infinite Crisis, so thank Rao for that one. With another crisis diverted, as well as a brand new roadmap of the multiverse provided to him by the now deceased Alexander Luthor, Ted Kord once again starts setting his sights higher. He poses the ultimate question to Brother Eye, and that is, statistically, what would I have to do to stop every crisis from happening? And, well, ultimately, he doesn't like the answer. To stop crises, all you have to do is get rid of the superheroes. Because, I mean, hey, we live in a world without superheroes and we're relatively safe, right? Our entire universe doesn't restart every 5 to 8 years. I mean, not that we know of or anything. Ted doesn't quite want to be a killer, though, so instead he devises an arguably much more hellacious way to stop the superhero community, and that is use the OMAC tech to convert them. Basically, he goes full-on Borg Queen, even fashioning himself a brand new suit complete with Brother Eye tech. He's not Blue Beetle anymore, he's the One Beetle Army Corps, or OBAC for short. Now, while Ted deals with the Justice Leaguers and adult superheroes, it was up to Superboy Prime to try and round up all the teen heroes. It doesn't go great because he's the wrong person to delegate to. Again, I'm not sure if Ted Kord, being such a genius, fully thought this through, but Superboy Prime is nuttier than squirrel shit. And once it's made abundantly clear that he's gonna start killing and not stop, Ted is ultimately forced to convert Superboy Prime as well. Probably should have started with that one, honestly. In the end, it ultimately comes down to a clash between Booster Gold and Blue Beetle, two former best friends now turned hated enemies. I gotta say, these last couple pages here are truly amazing. They actually restaged the whole Blue Beetle getting shot in the head scene, only now it's Booster holding the gun. And while Ted might not strike at his best friend Booster, the suit, now fully taken over by Brother Eye, will absolutely strike at him and kill him. Ted is truly horrified over what's happened, and this might actually have been enough to make him stop what he was doing, but Brother Eye can't have that now, can he? And as such, he'll just take control of his body fully. And with that, this universe will no longer experience any crises, and to think all it took was the destruction of all sentient organic life on Earth. Quite the trade-off, huh, as the comic comes to a close. And so that was Tales from the Dark Multiverse Infinite Crisis, issue number 1, everybody, and I gotta say, I really enjoyed what Tynan was doing here with this issue. Infinite Crisis is one of those books that I think has a lot of structural problems, a lot of characterization issues, and I think everyone at the time agreed they really hated that Blue Beetle moment, so I really like the idea that they've used that whole bit there as a jumping off point for this story. And even though they do it in a dark, macabre way, it's a nice way to shine a light on a lower tier character like Blue Beetle, who never does get a lot of respect, and yet clearly he's shown to be capable of so very much if only he got a chance to show. And ultimately, I thought this was another winner in a series that so far has been really solid. I would give this one an 8.5 out of 10. Good stuff.
Hey there, everyone, Kate Joel again, and I just want to thank you so much for watching to the end of the video. It means a lot to me. And hey, if you enjoyed the book I covered in this issue and want some comics of your own, might I recommend Book Depository? It's my number one place for shopping for comic book trades. You get a great price, and if you use my link down in the description, you'll actually be helping me out at the same time. You get something, I get something, everybody wins, right? So until next time, everyone, I've been Joel, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.